Problem number two, emerging pesticides in biological products. If you are working with cell cultures, you frequently see that you have problems with contamination with BVDV virus. Have you seen this problem? I am sure that you have seen it. Now we have realized that this is not only BVDV, because we have BVDV1 and BVDV2. But recently there are new viruses which actually first were developed or detected by the Germans, the Friedrich Loeffler Institute group. They had a fetal calf serum sample from Brazil, and they found a virus which is called Hobby virus. And we have now a similar virus from Thailand. And we have now a real-time PCR assay which is specific for these new pestiviruses. The story is shortly so that we had a BVDV serum collection which one of our PhD students came from Thailand with these samples. Of course, they were heat inactivated because we cannot import Thailand catalyst serum into Sweden without heat inactivation. And we have found some with antigen ELISA, we have found some positivity in this serum. And then we ran the PCRs, and we had, with a very conservative PCR assay, with a PAMPST PCR assay, we could amplify nucleic acid signals from this calf serum. But, and then we sequenced it, and then we found that these new viruses, together with the German Hobby virus, are a completely new group of bovine pestiviruses, which we recommend now to call BVDV3. But the problem was that we had PCR products, and that is a general critique against PCR, that we have PCR products, but we have no virus in our hand. What can we do? So from the sequences, like David mentioned today, there are very good techniques today that from the sequences, from the nucleic acid, we can run a transfection of the cells, and we can reconstruct the virus. And we have done it, so now we have this Thailand virus in our hand, and we can study it. We will now run a lot of experimental infections in Hungary to check the capacity of this virus, how is it replicating, and we are checking the virus. So now we have diagnostic systems for this new BVDV3 virus, and we are studying the in vivo characteristics of the virus. Problem number three, highly pathogenic avian influenza. We have heard a lot today from Ilaria and from other colleagues, so I don't have to repeat it, but you know, we have many open questions about the infection biology of these viruses. And we are in a very high need of better diagnostic techniques. For example, the sequencing through the cleavage site is a very, very time-consuming system. So we are now developing different assays. For example, microarrays based by Podlock probes. Podlock probes are very simple probes which look like this. They are going to find the target, as you see here, and then they close to be as a circular form if they find the target. And this new structure has a unique system and a general system. So you see the probe is finding the target, and then we have these circular probes. And actually, with the general amplification part, we can make a lot of copies with a general PCR. So what we do here, with a general PCR, we make a lot of copies of these Podlock probes. And then the Podlock probe has a specific tail, which can be hybridized on a solid phase microarray. So we are printing solid phase microarrays with this printer machine. And then finally, here is the result for highly pathogenic avian influenza virus. Podlock probes on these slides are now able to detect all the different variants of the H hemagglutinin and the neuraminidase subtypes of the avian influenza in one single platform. So instead of 25 separate reactions, we can identify the highly pathogenic avian influenza viruses, all variants, on a single platform within 4 hours. So this means that this is a very robust detection system for highly pathogenic avian influenza virus. And then the other assay which we developed, among other assays, are the new pathotyping assay with a CyberGreen real-time PCR assay. So this means that we are it's a very rapid and very robust real-time PCR assay. for the rapid detection of influenza viruses. And then we sequence these PCR products, and we can go further with the phylogenetic identification of the viruses. The Podlog probes were developed not only for highly pathogenic avian influenza, but also for the vesicular complex on swine and on cattle. The vesicular complex on swine are three important viruses: foot and mouth disease virus, swine vesicular disease virus, and vesicular stomatitis virus. And you know, all these three viruses are causing very similar disease symptoms, so it's very difficult to diagnose that this is foot and mouth and not foot and mouth. And if it is a foot and mouth, we have a completely different issue politically. So this Podlog probe assay, which was developed on a solid phase assay, it's detecting specifically here are the foot and mouth disease signals, here are the swine vesicular disease signals, and here are the vesicular stomatitis signals. So it means that we have a complex diagnosis of the vesicular complex within hours on a solid phase microarray. Problem group number 5, emerging viruses. We are talking about, for example, blue tongue. The problem is that the 24 serotype of blue tongue, or the 25th, which our Swiss colleagues found recently, they need a diagnostic assay which is very robust and detecting all the serotypes simultaneously. So here we developed a primer probe energy transfer system. This is a new real-time PCR assay, which has very high sensitivity, specificity, and it is able to detect all the 24 serotypes with different reactions within a very short time. So it means here are the amplification curves and here are the melting curves of this real-time PCR. If we talk about real-time PCR, I would like to ask you not to talk in general about real-time PCR, because there are today so many different variants of the real-time PCR. In general, we used to have the Tuckman methods, but now we have this primer probe energy transfer system, we have the CyberGreen system, we have the late PCR, we have many other PCR systems which are real-time PCRs, but they are all different. So the real-time PCR is getting very, very diverse now, and there are many advantages of the different real-time PCR methods. And here, for example, this primer probe energy transfer system is able to detect very, very robustly. This has a very big advantage, the primer probe energy transfer system compared to Tuckman, that it is not so sensitive for the point mutations in your target. So it means that you can have a very robust system which is not very much interested in the point mutation in your target. So this is very robust, and this is very important in the diagnostic laboratories. So if we go to problem number 6, emerging foodborne infections. We have not only transboundary animal diseases, but we have also transboundary food infections. And here, for example, the hepatitis cases, the human hepatitis cases caused by hepatitis E virus, and the same virus in pigs, hepatitis E virus. It's very important that we develop new real-time PCR assays, and here we developed the Tuckman assay and the primer probe energy transfer assay. And here you see, as I mentioned to you, two real-time PCR assays side by side. The sensitivity 1 to 10 copies, 1 to 20 copies, detecting all the four genotypes of the hepatitis E virus, and it is the reaction time, including the preparation, so it's very rapid. Both of them can be recommended, both the Tuckman and both the primer probe energy transfer system. They are amplifying all the four genotypes of the hepatitis E virus. And hepatitis E is getting a very big issue in Europe now. It was previously a traveler disease. If you went to Thailand or you went to Far East, you had these problems with hepatitis E. Unfortunately, now Europe is getting more and more infected with hepatitis E. So it means that, and the next question is that, is it exactly the same virus in pigs and in human beings or not? So that there are many very interesting issues in the hepatitis E subject also.